Hey, welcome back everybody. This is part 4 of my Clockwork Empires Revision 35 playthrough. I think I've gone through most of the usual explanatory stuff in all the previous parts. I've just been playing this one through so we can get to some of the cool new stuff. I intend to build a mine and maybe build a laboratory in this one, see where it goes. But first, I think I'll take a naturalist actually. Get some exploring done. And I have an immigration wave. Let's see. A lot of empty crews. Yeah, well, as we can see in the bottom right here, one of the immigrants was yet another NCO. How many do I have now? Oh, just the two, actually. Okay. Having a second NCO was good, then. And two workers. Let's, there we go. Let's take a look at our jobs. Butcher corpse. I assume they're referring to fishman corpses. Construct building. Alright, all that seems fine. I think our food production is fine. What did I say we were going to do last time? Ah, metalworking, that's right. So the first thing I'm going to build is, I've already built a ceramics workshop. This is the place where we'll build bricks. Do I have enough stone to complete these kilns? I do. So maybe I'll get started on the, I'd like to build a building here, but it's full of stumps. So I'm going to clear out this terrain, and then I'm going to start building the refinery. Our newly arrived naturalist hard at work, investigating the grass of the new world. It's just like the home counties. Let's clear this out here as well. I assume I might want to build here. I think I want to build my building in such a way that I can establish a perimeter. Right, so limit the angles of entry of fishmen and raiders and things. I mean, past builds I've very deliberately built in this sort of walled box fortress thing. It's kind of boring to look at, really. Let's enjoy the view of all our buildings with the roofs on. So as I record this, the last dev blog post was talking about their first revision to version 35, so 35A, which should be coming soon. In the blog post they said possibly today. And it was supposed to, so they've been focusing on UI polish and bug fixes and things. However, one exciting new thing, well I say exciting, one new thing that they mentioned was changes to the fog of war system. So as things stand right now, things are revealed by the fog of war by people walking through them, and then they just stay revealed forever. Like you mouse over them and you can see, even if you have no colonists there, you can still see everything that's happening in there. Like fishmen and bandits and animals that are just wandering through there, right? One of the changes they discussed was a second level of fog of war. Did I just build a second? Damn it! I was so busy talking that I didn't notice I had built a second ceramics workshop. However, this will give us an opportunity to use the new demolish button. Right? Every building in the top right here has a demolish building button. It's never quite worked properly for me. As I was saying, fog of war. Right now, things that are revealed by your colonists, they just stay revealed, right? So I can see this jungle fowl way off in the corner, even though I have no actual eyeballs up there. However, in other RTSs like StarCraft 2 and stuff, there's fog of war and then there's line of sight. So areas of the map you have never even seen once are black, but areas of the map clear this out. Areas of the map which you have seen are revealed, but they're not updated unless you have somebody there. So they're like they're revealed, but they're slightly grayed out, or they're slightly dimmer than areas in which you have an active population. And this is so that things can happen on the map. Things can happen in revealed areas without you being aware of them. This has implications for the eventual multiplayer. In that, you know, it needs to be possible for players to do things without other players knowing. And for it makes it possible for players to be surprised. Anyway, that's a hypothetical future change that is supposed to be done and in the works. Still waiting for some clear land, so now I'll just build it. Man. Really, I guess I could build right over these tufts of grass. It just bothers me. We see here, instead of using four logs or whatever, we've used one log and two bamboo poles. Because bamboo poles can be used in the place of logs. And then you can process bamboo poles in the carpentry workshop to turn them into planks. So in all ways, bamboo can replace wood. I don't think I need any more textiles at the moment. So I'm just going to empty out that work squad so they can work crew, so they can be useful elsewhere. So I'm going to try and demolish the ceramics building. Okay, I've clicked it 5 times. It turns out if I can't demolish it for whatever reason, I'll just let it stand as an empty building, or maybe I'll fill it full of cots. What's going on here? No, there's a fishman. It's the same color as my flax crops. No worries. Handily taken care of. Although I imagine he's upset my colonists. Right, we've cleared out a space. Ah, what the hell, I'll just build it over here. What I need instead of a ceramics workshop is a refinery. Well, and good, there we go. Let's see, we're going to be pulling in raw ore, so we need to be able to smelt it. Smelt raw ores into bars. Build 2 smelting crucibles, and the refinery is also where we make charcoal out of wood. I'm just going to put in 1 charcoal kiln for now. I can always build another one if it turns out I need a ton of charcoal for whatever reason. Come on. Well, demolished building doesn't seem to have appeared on the jobs queue either. Not really a problem, I guess, just a bit annoying. What am I growing in this field? It looks like weeds and Malfeasant claw bulb. Ah, corn. I'm gonna need a ton more stone than I have. It's a little too far away for my liking, given that I know fishmen like to hang out around there. It's phalerite. Well, unfortunately, it's the closest source of stone we have. We'll just cross our fingers, I guess. So once I get this refinery up and running, I'll build a mine. And then the next order of business will be a metalworks, so we can use our refined ores. And then I think we'll have all the pieces in place for a laboratory. Ah, good. The ceramics workshop is done. Let's get a crew in here. And I'm gonna turn all my brick in, or sorry, all my clay into brick. My stockpile seems to be full of booze. And not enough food. I think we've got enough of a work crew to tend to a second food crop plantation. I guess that's what I'll do here. I'm trying to drag out this farm plot, but it's getting stuck for some reason. I don't know what's going on here. Well, let's build somewhere else. There's a fishman. Well, he was beating up my bamboo. And I was trying to kill a man through a wall. So fishmen always seem to come from our current orientation, the southwest corner. Maybe I can take advantage of that. But not right now. Okay, let's see. 7 fishmen and 4 bandits. Oh dear. Let's take a look at our available military strength. Got 5 people. And a spare NCO. Alright, you guys aren't doing anything. You're going to be my emergency militia. So it's a military strength of 8. Actually, there we go. I hope I've got enough guns. In the meantime, we wait for our doom to find us. Why can't I drag it? I drag a farm out here, no problem. Chili peppers, why not? Let's make sure our military crews have the right priority set. They're not allowed to do anything but hang around the town square with guns. Oh my gosh, what's going on here? Supplies. I need all the guns. Somebody just set off a mine. Someone's hauling a corpse. Oh, good work, gentlemen. It took, like 5 soldiers all shooting at the armored bandit to take him out. Ah, what's going on? All right, call favor. I'm actually going to take a squad of redcoats. I have the prestige for it. So I'm going to spend all 5 of my prestige. I'm going to pause just so I can confirm it. Beautiful. I have an entire squad of soldiers. Our colony is back up to fighting strength. I have a ton of soldiers. And yet, some crops are spoiling. I imagine it's because life in the colony is that everyone's panicking and not not getting things done. The way crops can spoil is that they'll go through growth stages, right? I think 3 or 4. Like, you plant them, they grow for a little bit, and then they hit stage 1. And at stage 1, they wait for someone to come along and tend them before they grow to stage 2. If nobody tends them in time, they'll wither and die. Oh dear, look at all this food. I mean, giant beetles. Let's, well, who am I to look a gift horse in the mouth? So crops have like 4 stages, and if you don't tend each stage in time, it'll wither and then you won't get, it won't grow, right? You have to clear it and replant there. So what happened there was that since the entire colony was running around in a panic, some plants hit the end of their growth stage and no one was able to tend it, and so they withered. Which is not good, because it means all the work that a previous colonist put into there has been wasted. You're still not building this building, huh? Well, you're demolishing the building, I guess. Might as well use it for a... might as well jam some beds in there, then. I do notice, though, that that door is not being completed either. I mean, the door just should definitely have been finished by now if I hadn't issued the demolish order. Where was that herd of beetles? Huh. Oh, there they are. They did not get hunted. Just gonna wall up some of the gaps around my city while I have the opportunity. None of timber. I lack the logs to build a gabion. That is because I'm entirely out of timber. That is accurate. Right, more immigrants. What do I need? I don't think I need any more work. I don't think I need any more squads. I'm gonna take my usual 3 of anything. I have a population of 40 people. That attack is just 3 fishermen. I'm not even going to bother managing that one. Oh my god, come on. My 3 immigrants were an overseer and 2 NCOs. So, I have way more overseers than I need. I've just paused the game for a little bit. Well, I certainly don't need a militia NCO. These guys have no soldiers in their command. I am going to let them be hunters. Can't flag these guys for hunting either, which means they already have the hunt flag on them. One minor thing that still annoys me is that once you've successfully buried your own colonist in the graveyard, their bodies disappear and they get gravestones on them. But when you reload a saved, when you save that game and then load it, their corpses reappear. Now, according to the devs, actually, the game carefully preserves the information of a dead colonist at the time of his death, right? So we can see what this guy was thinking and this lady was thinking and, you know, her most recent thoughts and all of that. There's no in-game use for that stuff right now. But it's cool to have, and, you know, maybe at some point It'll be useful. Used for something. This is a little bit weird. So this building I marked for demolishing, none of the modules I've attached to it get completed, which, okay, makes sense. But the building itself is not demolished, and the blueprints hang around forever. But on the other hand, it's still considered inside for purposes of just being inside. Like, people prefer to do push-ups and sleep inside and stuff. And I think this guy, this lady might be another one of those who is stuck in a wall. She's eventually going to starve to death, and she... Maybe I can save her by building a door there. Alright, so the refinery is making good progress. We've established the chili plantation. Bamboo's coming in. The cornfields, well, they're not looking so good. Why am I still going? I certainly don't need any more flax. I should probably also turn this into... let's make sugar. Man, these soldiers sure love doing their push-ups. That's a fairly new animation, actually. That was added to the last couple of revisions, I think. I don't know if it benefits them, or... it was just something soldiers do when they're idle. Wow, Maud. She's a very professional soldier. Right, she ate raw food recently, which was adequate, but it didn't make her as happy as a cooked meal would have. So I need to find, actually, I think I'll be okay for logs once the next bamboo harvest comes in. But really, I am a little bit short. I would prefer... There we go. Alright. So we've got the crucibles set up in the smelter. Let's get a crew in here. Do I have any rot wars I can... No, I don't. No raw ores to begin smelting yet. But now at least I can consider there's a reason for me to mine them now. The sphalerite and hematite, so zinc and iron. I don't really need the zinc until much later, but the iron is always useful. And what I really need is copper. So they're the greenish mineral nodes, which I can't seem to find any of. Oh, here we go. Not a lot of copper in the surrounding hills. And we get copper out of malachite nodes. And the game is telling me I don't have enough... This soldier, this particular militia lady, try to build a gabion. But she couldn't find the timber. One of these people is starving. It might be this lady, because she appears to be stuck on the game geometry. I can try to save her by maybe moving this bed out of her way. That should work, right? Well, good enough. So, we've got mining going. Oh, the job list is full to overflowing. I'm actually going to try not to assign too many more jobs until we get some of these cleared up. colony is experiencing a bit of a wood shortage. Even though I've been deforesting the area around and growing bamboo, maybe I need to grow more bamboo. Huh. That's interesting. So in our demolished ceramics workshop, the one I built accidentally, the interior modules were completed, even though the doors were not. I mean, clearly the raw materials to build them are being delivered here. Ah, what? And now someone's building the door. Well, I don't know what to say there. I guess it's good. Ooh, gold. You know what? No, I'm not going to harvest this gold. Yet. It's cult talk happening. Generally, when I get the cult power notification, I scan around the colonist to see who might be talking purple thoughts. Right, the icon with the cultist in a hood. Or there's another icon of like a purpley eldritch swirl. Like Gertie Fledson sure seems to be talking about cults a lot. Robert Iron Robin. Our terribly miserable poet. Oh dear. Another lady who seems to be stuck in the geometry. Let's see if that helps. Well, moving that module doesn't seem to have done anything. So as you can see, there's still some collision issues, right, with, I better take food. Oh, that's a thing, crates can actually hit soldiers, or hit anyone. They can hit colonists and they'll gain an affliction. Even though it looks like it hit Hattie, I guess it didn't. But the people it does hit will get wounds. And given enough wounds, he'll be unhappy, and given too many wounds, you will die. Let's see. I know building materials option is broken, but I don't need any more... Actually, I do need more workers. So I'm going to take the criminal option. I think I was overly optimistic when marking out this territory for food, because I'm running out of storage space for conventional things, but my food stockpiles are very, very empty. I'll just make this a non-food stockpile. I see we got a couple of landmines, so I'm going to put them over here, where the fish people always seem to come. So we got, it's possible for goods to overlay each other, right? The food crate came down in this area. And we can see that it overlapped some of the stuff in the non-food stockpile. Fortunately, four fish people incoming, no big deal. Fortunately, it's not like things overwrite each other. And it's possible for things to occupy the same space under exceptional circumstances like that one. Right. I've got some ore coming in, hematite and malachite. I've got a crew assigned to the... Actually, I don't need... I'm looking at the wrong workshop. As I was saying, now that we have the facilities to smelt metal, I'm going to turn some of this hematite and some of this malachite into iron ore and copper ore. Well, that's weird. The rolling door that never got completed has just turned into a big hole in the wall. Someone's starving. I'll bet it's that colonist who's stuck in a wall. Yep. Don't really know what to do about you. Apparently I can't move this module. Right, like in blueprint mode, it's already been moved. I'm sorry, Gertie. I'm going to have to put you out of your misery. If she triggers the starvation warning one too many times, I'm going to lose prestige because the Empire gets word that colonists are starving, and then they send an emergency food drop. Like, starvation is not an actual real problem, right? It's just... I'm fine with killing her to avoid that bug for the greater good of the colony. Yep, that's how it all starts. Must eat a bullet for the greater good of the Empire. Now it makes sense for me to build a mine and also build a refinery. So those are the next two things I'm going to do. Alright, so this is going to be the mine superstructure. Actually, do I have the... I need iron plates and planks, which I have. Right. That's not what I wanted. A thing I don't use as often as I should is you can actually shift-click to place more than one thing at a time. For instance, I've got the mineshaft mark 1 selected. I'm going to place it with a shift-click, and I still have it under my pointer. So I can place another one. Right here. Right, and so when you're placing like 6 cots or whatever, it's a nice quality of life convenience thing. Mine under construction. Actually, the game is considerably more stable than it has been for a long time, which makes me very, very happy. But it's still not perfect, and we'll still suffer occasional mysterious crashes, and these will tend to become more and more probable as your game gets longer and longer and there's more opportunity for bugs. Huh. Maybe my soldiers can't find the path to Gertie. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to save the game. But I'm not going to end it here. I don't want this series to go on too long, but I still want to be able to show you all the cool new stuff. So I haven't caught saving the game on video before, I don't think. Because what I've tended to do in the past is pause the game, end the video, pause the game, and then attempt to save. Because there's a regrettable tendency for attempting saves to crash the game, and because it crashes during saves, you don't save and then you lose the game. Anyway, I'm just going to save it here, so if the game does crash, I don't lose the progress I've made here. Anyway, so while we have this moment to talk... never mind. Save successful. So we'll wait for the mineshaft to complete. There, we've cleared up a lot of the job queue. Next thing to do will be to assign a crew to be my miners. Still not happy about the state of my food production, though. I definitely need more food. I mean, that shipment of 15 food did nothing. Like, it got eaten immediately. One neat thing that happens now is that starving colonists will actually take it upon themselves to forage for food out in the wilderness. Which is, you know, it's intuitive, right? Like, you don't need that sort of thing explained to you, but it's a behavior that has to be deliberately entered into the game. I'm just going to take three of anyone. Naturalist, miner, laborer. I definitely did not need another naturalist. Man, I've got a pretty... Just like I have too many overseers for not enough laborers, I have way too many NCOs for not enough soldiers. Okay, clearly something's wrong here. I wonder if I have the components, I should say, necessary to build a still. I'm looking in the wrong menu. Brewery starts with a B. There we go. Still needs brick, iron sheets, copper sheets, metal pipes. Brick, iron sheets, copper sheets, metal pipes. Okay, why not? Let's build a still. What's the difference between the mechanical brewing tank and the still? Huh. Now the reason I'm building the still, even though I don't have enough corn to make chicha, is because the still is required to make rum. And rum is made from, you see that gray bucket there? That's actually a bucket of molasses, which is produced from sugar rather than corn. Which means I don't need to rely on the corn crop, but it does mean I need to grow sugar. Actually, I may have shot myself in the foot here. Well, it's time to grow some sugar. Alright, the chili harvest has come in. How are we doing for... Well, the kitchen is still busy pumping out food, which is good. I've actually got coconuts and chili. I can make coconut chili. Here, coconut curry. Let's make a standing order. Coconut curry always has priority over stew. Right. So we've got a work crew in here. We've got one operating mineshaft module. The second nearly complete. Pardon me. We'll start seeing miners going in and out of there. Oh dear. Gertie Brazen Sanderton. She got stuck in the crack between the brewing vat and the wall and starved to death. Not the most heroic tale out of the colonies. But I guess they can't all be winners, right? Oh. Soldiers are having a push-up contest out in the fields. Wow, that sugar cane grew very quickly. Maybe I don't need two fields full of sugar cane. Right, kitchen. I want you to prioritize making rum, or making molasses, over stew as well. Seems to be a bit of a bug here. This is a fishman steak, clearly. But it says standing order for stew. Ah, the beautiful still. The apex of our civilization. Looks like I'm out of storage room again. A little bit of metal smithing has been happening. I think I'm going to have to expand our stockpiles. But not like that. I mean, you don't have to make all your stockpiles contiguous. Right? They could be entirely arbitrary. They don't even have to be, like, that little... Individual squares don't have to be connected. I just like the way they look when I do it that way. Ah, beautiful mines. Huh, I've got a supply drop. I guess I have no option but to take food. Got 15 food. I didn't catch where that crate landed. Landed somewhere. Favor from the Empire. What do I need? A naturalist? I'm actually going to take... What is this? My fourth naturalist? Anyway, let's take a look. One, two. Naturalists are these guys with the goggles and the blue shirts and the white vests. It's one, two, three. Well, I've only got three naturalists, which is fine. At this point, I want more naturalists so they can be exploring things and hopefully digging up mysterious artifacts. An increasingly large percentage of my population is busy farming. So I've got a ton of farming plots. Which I think is kind of just a byproduct of the way the game works at present. Like, as your population grows, you'll need to increase the capacity, your capacity to feed them. But that seems to grow faster than the population. So the more people you have, the larger a percentage of your population must be farmers. So I think at some point it's not going to be, with very, very large colonies, it might be impossible to produce enough food. Like food production via farms and kitchens, it should scale up, right? But it's possible that it doesn't. Or you need to find efficiencies. With new modules, I mean, the devs have talked about canneries, which need glass and tin and things like that, and, you know, steam cookers, which is how they preserved food in, like, Napoleonic era and stuff. You might need specialized buildings. Otherwise, you know, it's like the move, it's like, that was the whole thrust of the industrial age, right? More efficiencies lead to growth. If you're stuck as an agrarian society limited by your basic food production, then you won't be able to sustain a large enough population to accomplish big things. You can't, if everyone has to be farmers, no one has time to be watchmakers, for instance. But that's my poli-sci history background coming into it. What I really ought to be worrying about is building a metalworks. Which I'm going to do right here. It's very important for your buildings to have doors. Wait, do I have bricks this time? I have just enough brick. I would definitely like some more, though. Where is my... which one of these buildings makes brick? I wish it was a little bit easier to tell, because once you've built modules for these things, they kind of look all the same. I have an order for brick, but nobody's making brick. Grover Rivet. Yes, this is... maybe it's because I have no clay. That is exactly the reason I'm not getting any brick. There we go. That should provide us enough brick. I'm going to mine this one anyway. Are these beetles dead? Huh. Well, no sense letting good protein go to waste. Oh, this one's still alive. So, hopefully, my colonists will grab the brick, dig up the brick with their shovels, bring it back to town, where some other dude will take his armload of raw brick to the kiln. I'm sorry, when I was saying brick, I should have said clay. Seven fishermen, no big deal. Right, so here we have workers digging up clay with their shovels. They're gonna bring it back to the middle of town, where someone else will probably pick it up from the stockpile, take it to the kiln, turn the clay into brick, put the brick back in the stockpile, and somebody else will take that brick, bring it over here, and build a metalworking, the smithing forge. Man, I am having trouble keeping my colonists fed. I think I'm going to have to turn off the beer production, just so more of the corn... more of the corn can go toward food production. This is, has become a race against time. Can I build a laboratory before starvation? Oh, it's a giant lizard. It's a dead giant lizard. It got hunted to death. This was introduced a couple of revisions ago. It's kind of like a giant, colorful Komodo dragon. It's not aggressive toward your colonists, I don't think, but it will eat your crops. I'm butchering every fishman I kill because we desperately need the food. We have so much booze. Right, this building is still waiting on metal sheets and brick. Actually, that's going to consume all my remaining metal sheets. So I'm going to make, now that I have some iron ore, yes, iron ingots. Ah, damn it. Can't turn iron ingots into iron sheets without the metal works. Oh, here we've just witnessed a module breaking. In this case, it was the carpentry workshop, I believe, or the carpentry workbench. Things that are broken will continue to work. It's just an indication of their declining durability. The more they're used, the more their durability declines. First they'll show up in this damaged state, and then eventually they'll just break entirely. They can be repaired, you look at the bottom right here, it says the workbench is damaged. Repairing it requires timber. I've got timber. I should say I've got logs, which I hope is what they want. And repairs happen automatically. They're just another one of those spontaneous jobs. So the next colonist who has the ability to pick up a free job, go to the stockpile, grab a log, or in this case, a bamboo pole, and... Well, okay, so he took the hauling job, but he didn't take the repair job. So the next guy after him, who has a chance, will come here, and it's like building a door. He'll just hammer it into shape and use this resource. And then it'll be fixed. So the idea of durability and maintenance is very important, since we've also introduced sustainability with this latest patch. That's revision 35, right? Now that we can grow our own wood and produce our own minerals with the bamboo plantation and the mines, respectively, we don't want an unchallenging infinite source of supplies. So things will now break down as well. And it's maintaining your colony's ability to produce is measured by your ability to sustain the mechanisms that make that colony possible. I think this guy might be repairing... there we go. It seems weird to be repairing a workbench. But there we go. So our brick got made. Some of it's already been delivered. I'm going to try and build a lab. All the modules that go in the lab are pretty expensive. They need things like glass, finished metal parts. So I'm going to build the superstructure first, and then... and then we'll see what resources we need to build all the interior modules. I'm going to build the mad scientist lab out here on the outskirts of town, where all crazy laboratories should go. Halfway through a log, apparently. Let's clear this out. What I'd really like to see is for workers to auto-clear terrain before you build a building. That makes sense, right? Like, clear the grass and the broken logs and things. Okay. Park a chemistry workbench here. Macroscope. The vacuum chamber. So terribly expensive. I'll get back to you. Definitely don't need more NCOs or overseers. I guess I'll take three of anyone. Again, I'm trying to change the overseer-laborer balance. Don't need quite so many overseers. Maybe I should start shooting them. I'd say I got a forester, laborer, and a foot soldier. That's good. Not a single overseer. Anyway, I was looking at modules. Consider the macroscope. Copper tube, two copper plates, cogs, glass. Copper tube, copper plate, cogs, glass. I believe I can build a macroscope. It's like a microscope. But instead of making little things bigger, it makes little things bigger. Okay, that didn't... That sounded much wittier before I said it. Anyway, with three naturals going full bore, hopefully one of them will dig up a, perhaps dig up a fishy artifact or a mysterious idol. Actually, I believe they're actually called fishy idol and mysterious artifact. I'm not producing booze anymore because, well, A, we have a ton of it, and B, we need all the constituent ingredients of booze to make food. See, the sugar harvest is coming in. We'll soon be able to make, actually, what am I going to do with the sugar if I don't have, if I'm not making rum? Can you eat buckets of molasses? I think you can eat sugar loaf. I hope you can, because that's our only crop. In the meantime, I'm going to take food. Always just barely skirting the... some food landed in my textile mill. Artisan, workers, take yet another naturalist. So the lab superstructures have been built. No point assigning anyone in here until we've also got some of the modules made. Here we have guys coming out of the mines with random things. This guy dug up clay and this guy dug up sand. I should actually turn some of that sand into glass. Is this my refinery? Yes, it is. How much sand do I have? 3 bushels of sand. When you guys are done making bricks, I want you to make glass, and we'll use that in the vacuum chamber. So I've got 50 colonists in various different locations, and this is day 14, which is pretty good, as like the game hasn't crashed yet. I haven't seen any significant bugs. I've seen minor pathfinding issues and people getting stuck in walls and stuff. But I haven't seen any of those script errors that will just like get the game stuck in an infinite loop. The game's not done, right? But clearly it's in a much better place than it used to be. As bugs get systematically squashed. So there's 8 fishmen coming in from somewhere. Let's watch the fine soldiers of the Empire at their work. Thank you for your gift of flesh. Right, so this whole battle happened, I didn't have to micromanage any of it. Like, I'm successful at these encounters because I've set up, in theory, because I've set up a working supply chain, which allows me to support a body of soldiers who are able to operate autonomously. And that's sort of the macro versus micro management side of this game. It was a deliberate design choice on the part of the devs to say this is a supply logistics game rather than a micromanagement game. So it's a very different kind of game than, say, like, I don't know, like Age of Mythology or StarCraft II or... and it's closer akin to something like Banished. And it's definitely got like Nomoria and Dwarf Fortress in its DNA. Also got a ton of resources. If only I could eat some of this ore. They look like chunks of candy. Maybe it's just Maybe it's just my colony has been skirting along with just barely adequate food for so long. Everything looks like food now. It's like when Bugs Bunny and Sylvester are stuck on a deserted island with no food, and like one of them looks at the other one and he just sees a talking roast chicken. I hope you guys like coconuts. So we've got a tiny little bit of food stored up. So this is raw, inedible sugarcane. But it's better than zero. Which is what we had for a long time. You know, I don't think we need... Actually, we'd better keep up the bamboo production. All the bamboo we make is being used immediately. And there are practically no... There are very few timber trees in the surrounding area now. So let's see, this is bamboo, we're going to keep this. This is chilies, we're going to keep those. You know, I started growing sugar thinking I'd make rum, but I definitely need the food more. So I'm going to turn this into a corn plant after the current sugarcane harvest. Didn't I have one more field? Ah, here we go. This is also a sugarcane field. You also need to be corn. Let's see how our laboratory is doing. Oh, good. Why is it full of sleeping people? No matter. Clearly it's because they are too far from the beds. I think I'm going to order up some more bricks. I've got more bricks on the way, I don't see why... I guess that should be okay. Anyway, as I was saying, I'm going to build a second... smithy on top of my metalworks, and I should now have the ability to produce any module that I need out of raw materials, which is to say I should be able to manufacture it out of like iron ores and stuff rather than hoping for the correct components to drop from the sky. Now I don't have enough bricks in stock. Yes I do. Going to say I don't have enough bricks in stock to make the second smithing forge, but I guess some just completed production. Still got 3 bolts of cloth, so I'm going to build some more beds in here. Now the next thing to do once I have a lab is to assign a crew to it. Mr. Chuzzlewit and his truthful presses. Just gonna pause for a second here. The squad that gets assigned to a lab, their overseer, assuming I can find him, becomes a scientist. Oh, Mrs. Chuzzlewit. Right? And all of the workers under her command become lab assistants. So both scientists and lab assistants are capable of using the macroscope and also the vacuum chamber to research mysterious artifacts. Next thing I'm going to build is the vacuum chamber. Or attempt to build the vacuum chamber because it's enormous and enormously expensive. What does it need? Two copper pipes, a cog, a bucket of cogs, 2 copper sheets, and 1 glass. Actually, okay, it's less expensive than I thought. 2 of these, 2 of these, one of these. Huh. Well, that's fine then. Do I have the cogs, actually? I do. Well then, I'll have no trouble making the macroscope. So, that's about the technological limit of the game so far. I mean, there's a couple buildings I haven't built yet. Like, I haven't built the chemists, which you use to make fertilizer and military supplies. I have not built the armory, which uses finished metal parts to make guns, like pistols and then like two different kinds of rifles. I don't feel like the security of the colonists is threatened. It's pretty stable, food issues aside. I mean, but we're still getting some food in, so even if we're not able to sustain our current population with our current level of food production, death by starvation will be slow and lingering. And, you know, not terribly exciting to watch. So, I'm going to wrap this episode up here. It's gone on super long. But I will, assuming it doesn't crash when I try to save this, I will continue this on. I'm not going to video my entire playthrough from this point on, but if I manage to capture research happening, and possibly the fishy transformation, and then I'll be able to post it in a follow-up video. But otherwise, I mean, I think this is a pretty good look at what Clockwork Empires has to offer right now. So again, the game's not done. It's currently revision 35 in early access on Steam. Hopefully you can see why I enjoy playing this game and what sort of gamer this might appeal to. Thanks very much for sticking with me for this particular playthrough. Keep playing Clockwork Empires, I guess. Have a good one.